Well, it didn't work again, but that's what happens when you have a full flight.
Hi, we're Ruben and Rebecca, and we specialize in quick trips on a budget. We recently took a trip to Norway and want to share with you our opinion of Norse Atlantic Airways.
Norse Atlantic is one of the newest airlines that flies across the Atlantic for destinations like Norway and England. And the prices are awfully attractive. But we looked at the reviews, which were mixed, and we're wondering, what are we gonna get?
Our experience started at LAX, and we got off to a bit of a rocky start. All passengers have to check in at the ticket counter, regardless of whether you have bags to check or not. And this took a good hour and a half.
There are lots of extras that you can pay for, including checked bags and carry-on. As far as under the seat, they're very strict about the size.
What are we waiting for?
We're waiting for a bus to take us to the terminal that our plane is actually parked at. So, interesting.
So, here's another interesting thing. Where we checked in is not where the plane is. We had to hop a bus and head to another terminal. Yet another reason to arrive very early if you're flying out of LAX.
Because Norse charges for all food and drinks, we stocked up on snacks before we boarded. So what trick did we use, hoping we'll get this row to ourselves?
We got A and C. Hopefully nobody takes the
seat. I hope no one wants the seat.
We will find out.
There.
The old A seat, C seat trick did not work. And the reason is because when Norse Atlantic sells tickets, they just sell a ticket, not a particular seat.
We were surprised to find the media options were free and a really good selection. But you do need to bring your own earphones unless you want to pay.
As we said, R&R did not buy the food on the plane. But if you did, it was 30 bucks a meal and you had to pre-order 24 hours in advance. And they did not look great.
Norse Atlantic didn't have window shades, they have a dimmer button, but unfortunately mine wasn't working.
But everything else seemed to be fine. The seats were nicely spaced, we had plenty of room, they reclined, they were average and just like any other flight that you take.
Tip, if you're arriving into Oslo, there's a train station right there in the airport that makes it easy to get into the city center. We had a fantastic time in Norway. We visited three different cities, and you can check out our videos on Oslo, Flåm, and Bergen. Make sure you subscribe.
The check-in at Oslo was a much different experience. Everybody did have to check in. For some reason, there's no online check-in. But other than that, things were pretty smooth. We were in the terminal that we flew out of. No extra trips necessary. Overall, our experience on Norse Atlantic was pretty positive. No major complaints. You get what you pay for, and if your expectations are low, they'll probably be exceeded.
We got
cross your fingers and your toes.
Well, it didn't work again, but that's what happens when you have a full flight. We tried.
Los Angeles flight time will be around 10 hours and 20 minutes. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the flight. Then you'll be taking good care of it. Once again, welcome aboard and enjoy the flight, everyone.
We noticed several upset passengers who tried to order a meal and were told that since they hadn't pre-ordered one 24 hours in advance, they'd have to wait to see if there were any extras. It's important when you're flying a budget carrier to read all the rules and restrictions so you don't have any unpleasant surprises. Our experience flying Norse Atlantic in basic economy is that it's a no-frills airline that gets you to Norway for a low price, and for budget travelers like us, that works out just fine.